Subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates.
I'm at GTB Nagar Hospital with Mr. Alok Kumar of the VHP. He's also the International Working President of the Vishva Hindu Parishad. Today, Mr. Kumar has visited the riot-affected areas in Northeast Delhi from Chandbagh, Noor-e-Ilahi, Shiv Vihar, Karawal Nagar and Maujpur, visiting families of the victims who were affected in the riots. So let's speak to... Sir, if you could tell us first, you know, who are these families who you visited and what did you find, sir?
Well, I met the families who have lost somebody in there from amongst them or have suffered some serious injury. I found that this is a tragic experience. Most of the people who have died came from lower middle class families, were migrants, were doing small jobs, had young wives, small kid. And the immensity of loss for the left out family, the widow and children, is lifelong and very painful.
And sir, if you could tell us a bit more of these families, their background, where they came from.
I gave you the details. Most of them migrants from western Uttar Pradesh villages, people young. 25 to 35.
And looking at the damage which was done, sir, in these riots, what did you, from being on the ground, what did you find that who were the one who started these riots and who conducted this large-scale violence and what do you make of it?
Well, I can say that the riots were triggered from the Muslim side. There was premeditation and a preparation had gone into it, including in collection of firearms and brickbats. So the trigger came from them, and the Hindus fought back in exercise of their right to self-defense.
So when you're saying that in most of these areas, because you went to Chandbagh, Noor-e-Ilahi, Shiv Vihar, so in all of these areas, it was the Muslim community which started the riots?
That's my understanding, yes.
And you visited mainly the most the people affected by the riots were mostly Hindus who you affected, sir?
I visited the Hindu victims.
And the amount of damage, if you can explain, what is the amount of damage which the families who have faced?
The amount in monetary terms I would not be able to assess. I am satisfied that the government of Delhi has come out with a compensation package and is trying to distribute it with swiftness. But then the society is also taking initiatives. The Hindu organizations have also collected relief material.
And can you tell us more about the VHP's plan about how to help these people further and who the VHP, if you're working with the government to get aids or to help these people on the grounds?
We are working on all levels. We are helping these families to fill up forms, to have the survey done, to get the compensation. We are also appealing to the philanthropists to donate money and material. And we have provided the first installment of aid to almost all such families.
And sir, if you can also tell us that, you know, you had earlier mentioned that the VHP and the RSS is working together, sir. So if you could also explain the level of work together and essentially about that.
I don't understand that question, the level of work. I said we are covering 100% of the victims.
And also, sir, just wanted to understand that you were here at the GTB hospital, sir. Do you have any plans of meeting? Do you have any of meeting the victims here at the hospital? How long were you here?
I met the medical director. I obtained all the requisite informations. He advised me not to meet the patients admitted here, and he said that it might that the frequent meetings with them interrupts the medical course. So I accepted his advice.
And sir, you had earlier mentioned that most today you've been on the ground since 10 a.m. Till at least 4 p.m. So most of the victims who you mentioned come from Hindu families, sir. Do you have any plans of meeting those Muslim communities who are impacting the riots, sir?
I would not know if I would be welcome there. But then the riot affects all people, the Hindus and Muslims. Where a Muslim young man dies leaving a widow, the results are as disastrous as for a Hindu. Therefore, the victimhood, the loss for all of the people affected in the riots is equally tragic. They should all be supported, and the people of India should make all efforts that the riots are not repeated anywhere.
So you said that you don't know if you would be welcome there. Do you see a point where, you know, you might want to work on that? As you said that the riot or the damage done is whether it's a widow, irrespective of the faith, the damage is the same. So do you see yourself working on or going there?
I'm not sure if that can happen at this stage. But then at some stage, we all meet as Indians, as children of Bharat Mata, work together for peace and amity. For example, we saw after the Ayodhya verdict.
Sir, also wanted to know, sir, that there are few reports which have come that, you know, certain people who did strike in the riots were people supposedly from the RSS, sir. So how would you respond to these reports?
I would say I have no information, but I would add that in the case of a riot, when a mob attacks, the Hindus have a right of self-defense. And if any RSS or VHP people have, along with the society, resisted the attack, I am proud of them.
So you're saying that it was not the Hindus who then struck first, if they did at all, if they struck back in self-defense, is what you're saying?
They resisted in self-defense. I did not say struck back.
They resisted in self-defense, and you are proud of their action.
Proud if they acted in self-defense.
This is Revati Krishnan for The Print.